Hello from Chem Help ASAP. Let's learn about the initiation of radical reactions. At the top of the screen, we have our mock radical reaction. This is our net reaction. To start this process, we need a molecule called a radical initiator. The initiator is a molecule that easily forms radicals. The initiator might be one of the reagents that appears in the reaction, or it might be a separate molecule that does not appear in the net reaction. Our radical reactions will involve initiators that are reagents in the net reaction. In our mock reaction, let's assume that AB serves as the radical initiator. If AB is the initiator, a sigma bond and AB will break homolytically, so we're using fishhook arrows, to form two new radicals, A dot and B dot. So we've gone from no radicals on the left to two radicals on the right. That's exactly what happens during the initiation stage. This simple reaction is the initiation stage. Why would this bond break? Only because energy has been put into the system. Some initiators form radicals with heat, a Greek delta, and others require light, written as H with the Greek letter nu. H nu kind of looks like HV. The heat or light is enough energy to break that AB bond. Common initiators. Include dihalides, like Cl2, Br2, I2, NbS, N-bromosuccinimide, and hydrogen peroxide, H2O2. The dihalides and NbS, these tend to be light activated. Hydrogen peroxide tends to be heat activated. This initiation reaction might give the sense that all the AB molecules in the reaction form A radicals and B radicals. That's not true. Just a tiny fraction of all the AB molecules will homolyze into radicals. The vast majority will remain as AB. In other words, even after initiation, the concentration of radicals in the reaction is very low. That's okay though, because even just a small number of radicals is enough for the overall reaction to proceed quickly. So that's the initiation stage. A molecule which may or may not be part of the overall reaction serves as the initiator and decomposes in the presence of light or heat to form radicals.